Microsoft's May 2020 update for Windows 10 brings the addition of cloud recovery to the operating system, making it much easier to reinstall Windows using new installation files downloaded from Microsoft. Cloud recovery reinstalls and resets Windows using new installation files. This can be useful if you're experiencing issues with your current Windows installation, but do not wish to worry about drive partitions or creating installation media. Cloud recovery can be used within Windows or from the Advanced Options boot screen if you are unable to boot into Windows. To follow this tutorial, you'll need to ensure that you're running Windows 10 with the May 2020 update installed, which is version 2004 or newer. Downloading the necessary installation files in this tutorial can use up to more than 4 GB of data. Before we continue, it is important to understand that you will want to have backed up any files you wish to keep to an external medium, whether it be a USB drive or cloud storage service. The methods I show in this tutorial will remove all data, including files and applications, from your system's drive. Your data is your responsibility. RichTech is not responsible for any loss of data following this tutorial. To get started, open the Settings app and go to Update and Security. From here, you'll want to select Recovery from the menu on the left-hand side. Under Reset this PC, click Get Started to begin the process. This will bring up the wizard where we can select our options and customize any of the settings. As we're looking to go for a clean installation experience, select Remove Everything. Now we can choose to use the Cloud Download feature or use existing Windows recovery files located on the system. We'll be using the cloud download for the advantages mentioned at the start of the tutorial. By default, some options are already selected, but this can be customized if you wish to do a more thorough deletion of data on your drive, or erase all your drives and not just your Windows drive. Double check that you're happy with the options selected and then continue. You'll then have a final chance to double check everything and then click Reset to begin. Windows will now start to download the installation files it needs and restart automatically. When it's done, you'll be greeted by the Windows setup and can configure your computer as if it were new. If you're struggling to get to the desktop, but can reach advanced startup, you can still make use of cloud recovery to reinstall Windows. To use cloud download within advanced startup, your computer will need to be connected to the internet via Ethernet. Advanced startup can be started from the same recovery section of the settings app as the previous method, or you can find it by clicking restart on your start menu or lock screen whilst holding the shift key. It may also automatically load if your computer is struggling to boot. If advanced startup isn't obtainable, you may want to look into reinstalling Windows 10 using external installation media. Click the link at the top right of the screen to learn about that. When you've loaded into advanced startup, select Troubleshoot from the initial list of options and then select Reset this PC. As we're looking to go for a clean install experience, select Remove Everything and your computer will restart into the resetting procedure. From here, we can now select Cloud Download and, if you have multiple drives, choose whether you want to remove the data from only the Windows system drive or all of the drives connected to the computer. You'll also have the choice between a more thorough data removal or a faster process. Before clicking Reset, Windows will give you the opportunity to double check the choices you have made, and when you're ready to continue, click Reset. Your computer will begin to download the files it needs and begin the resetting process. When it's done, you'll be greeted by the Windows setup and can configure your computer as if it were new. So there you have it. Windows has been reinstalled on your system using new Windows installation files downloaded from Microsoft. Windows should be able to find most of the drivers it requires automatically, but you may still need to install some specialized drivers such as graphic drivers manually, depending on your system configuration. So that's been it for this video. If you found it helpful, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.